Here I'm done with my first layer. Now we'll move on to second layer. Second layer I'll be sticking like one petal in between the two petals. I'll show you. See, this is my two petals, 1, 2, and I stick this, then I stick this, okay, like this. I'll be completing my this circle. Okay guys, I forgot to tell you how I embossed these petals. Right, I'm already done with my all the petals, but I'll show you on the other petal that how I did the embossing. First we'll finish the flower and then I'll show you how I completed my embossing and which color I used. Here I'm done with my second layer. Now I'll start with the third one. Again, this will be the same, one petal in between two, and it has to be like, you know, you have to maintain the level of your petals. What I mean by the level is this, where you are sticking your petals, they have to stick on each other, like, you know, you have to maintain this level. You don't have to go downwards or go upwards from the your first petal or your first circle. So if you maintain this level, you automatically get this structure, this formation. If you go, if you stick your petals above or you go below, your flower will not look like this. So in when you are making flowers, maintaining the level, or if you want to change the labels according to your flower formations, these are quite important. These are basic things, but which are very important. done with the my third layer. Okay, for this flower, and I'm done with my this one flower. So now we'll add the calyx. For adding calyx, what I'm going to do is, taken this die, I don't know the name of this die cut. This has a 5 petals, it's a 5 petal flowers. I cut it in a green foam and I colored with the brown color. Now let's pick it. And I'm going to stick this with the little glue inside.